An elderly woman tasered by police in New South Wales is now receiving end-of-life care. Local priest Father Mark Croker shared the update. He says Ms. Nowland, who suffers from dementia, looks peaceful, adding she's not conscious but certainly looks comfortable. Police are considering changing how they train officers to deal with the elderly.
But if it does lead to a review, a need for additional training, different training in response to people with dementia or any other person with a cognitive impairment, then we will do so.
The 95-year-old woman was critically injured by a police taser in a nursing home 5 days ago, falling to the ground and hitting her head. Buy now, pay later services like Afterpay and ZipPay are set to undergo a sweeping overhaul as part of a government crackdown on the sector. Live 2 political reporter Rachel Baxter in Canberra. Rachel, good morning. What are the changes on the way?
Good morning, Anne. Well, the hope is that this will bring more protection for consumers, but it'll also make it a fair bit harder to access these services. The Assistant Treasurer will announce the changes today, but he will say that if it looks like credit and acts like credit, it should be treated like credit, and therefore these buy now, pay later products should be regulated under credit laws. What that means, well, it'll mean service providers will need to make sure a person can afford to use the products, fees for missed payments will be capped, and companies will need measures to handle financial hardship situations so that people don't get caught out with multiple debts and multiple repayments. Treasurer Jim Chalmers says the changes should have been made a long time ago.
These are very popular products, something like 7 million accounts in Australia. They have a legitimate role to play in our financial system, but we need to make sure that we are managing the harm and managing the risks.
Having an oversight in making sure, particularly, that those have a credit licence, in making sure there's responsibility of the way in which they lend, is an important reform that I think should be looked at with merit.
Now, $16 billion was spent by some 7 million Aussies using these services last year. So it's a lot of people, a lot of money, and the government says that is why it is time for a crackdown. Anne?
Rachel Baxter in Canberra. Thank you, Rachel. First home buyers in New South Wales could soon receive a helping hand from the state government. Under a new proposal, the stamp duty exemption cap will be lifted to $800,000. It'll be introduced before Parliament this week, promising savings of more than $31,000.
We went to the election with a clear policy, and we do have a mandate, therefore, to introduce this legislation into the Parliament.
It would require buyers to live at their chosen property for 12 months instead of six. The Victorian government is expected to reveal a multi-billion dollar bill to pay off its COVID lockdown debt in tomorrow's budget. Government jobs are set to be slashed to counter the rising costs, Tegan Dolling reports.
The state government is pointing its finger at the RBA, saying that a lot of its spending and borrowing decisions was based on initial outlooks made by the RBA. We are expecting $165 billion debt in tomorrow's budget. A lot of that is around our COVID lockdowns. $30 billion needs to be repaid because the government was obviously forking out a lot of money to ensure small businesses could remain open and that people could keep food on the table.
COVID was right around the country, Nat, not just in Victoria, but for some reason, Victorians are copping the brunt of this COVID repayment that we read about in the newspapers yesterday. A tax at a time when families, when singles, when people right around this great state can least afford to pay it.
We're likely to see public sector jobs go. There's a chance that there's 372 programs on the chopping block, things like critical road maintenance and domestic violence. We could even see our car rego and stamp duty increase.
A 40-year-old Australian man has died while descending Mount Everest. South Australian Jason Kennison died on Friday. His father has now been notified by local police. At the age of 23, Mr. Kennison was in a car accident and had learned to walk again. He was using his climb to raise funds for Spinal Cord Injuries Australia. His body is yet to be recovered. The date for the state memorial for the late Barry Humphreys has been announced. The ceremony will be held on the 15th of December at the Sydney Opera House. It'll be co-hosted by the Australian and New South Wales governments after an offer was accepted from Humphreys' family. More details on the service will be released later this year. A team of private astronauts have left Earth this morning, flying to the International Space Station. It opens up the idea of ticket-paying passengers heading to space. US correspondent Tim Lester has the story.
Houston-based company Axiom is very open about its fare-charging flights to space, with one exception. It's not saying what a ticket costs.
Dragon, SpaceX, go for launch.
The skies over Florida's Cape Canaveral kind to Axiom and the four crew.
Engines full power. And liftoff, Falcon 9, go Axiom.
Perched on top of a SpaceX rocket. Lift off this morning, special for several reasons.
A great view of Falcon 9 heading to space.
Aboard, the first woman to lead a private space flight, 63-year-old Peggy Whitson, a veteran astronaut, but her crew paying customers, like John Schaffner, a pilot who made his fortune in telecommunications and a hardware company.
I feel like I've been preparing this my entire life. I've been a fan of space since I was a child.
Also on board, the first woman from Saudi Arabia to go to space, Rayana Banawi, a biomedical researcher. She and her colleagues to join 8 days of scientific work aboard the International Space Station. What they paid to fly is confidential, though Axiom previously cited the equivalent of $82 million for a single seat to space. Also on show today, the return of the rocket booster, an impressive landing back on the pad at Cape Canaveral.
There you can see.
The crew now well into a 16-hour journey to the International Space Station. Axiom ultimately plans to build its own space station, then sell who knows how many tickets to fly there.
Police are appealing for information over a frightening armed robbery at a McDonald's in Melbourne. A masked man can be seen approaching the counter and threatening a worker with a knife. They filled a bag with cash from the till and the suspect ran away. It happened in February at Kingsbury. Fire crews in Sydney have spent the night battling a grass fire which broke out on the grounds of a school in Freshwater. It was a delicate operation to contain the flames which burned around an electrical box. Annie Pullar reports.
Good morning. Fire has ripped through school grounds here at Northern Beaches Secondary College in what police are now investigating as a suspicious arson attack. It was just before 8 o'clock last night. Residents in Freshwater spotted flames leaping from a nearby substation on Bennett Street, spreading to bushland inside the school.
She saw all this orange lapping around and she opened the door and said, come quickly. And I came out and the fire was surrounding the meter box, but wasn't in the meter box, but it was right around it, and the flames would have been 15 feet into the air, I guess.
Fire crews were quick on scene and managed to contain the fire, preventing damage to the substation itself, which could have easily ignited a far bigger blaze. Investigators are still working to determine a cause, but several witnesses say they spotted a man running from the school grounds right before the fire started. The Department of Education says the incident has not affected school operations today. Fire investigators are expected to arrive here later this afternoon to assess the scene.
Mental health was once again the focus for Prince William when he joined a crew of submariners training for a challenge to row across the Atlantic. After he was introduced to the group, he put his own rowing skills to the test, completing a few laps of a lake. It was all for a charity supporting the health and well-being of those who have served and now retired. A defiant Volodymyr Zelensky insists Russian forces have not occupied the city of Bakhmut. The Russian Wagner military group claims to have captured the eastern city, the site of the war's longest and bloodiest battle. Zelensky's comments came during his visit to Hiroshima. He compared Bakhmut to the Japanese city, which was ravaged by an atomic bomb in World War II. Climate activists have turned the water in Rome's famous Trevi Fountain black. The protesters poured diluted charcoal into the water and unfurled banners slamming Italy's use of fossil fuels. Shocked tourists filmed the stunt as police waded through the water to arrest the activists. The mayor of Rome says they will have to replace 300,000 litres of water.